With the 15th pick in the 2022 NFL Draft, the Houston Texans select Kenyon Green, Texas A&M.
Listen up, y'all, it's the run game. Josh and Leo igniting the flames. We bring the heat, no room for shame. Texas 22, we ain't playing no games. Hosting the show, we got the flow, breaking it down, let you all know. Every week we bring the hype, talking the downs and making it right. Ooh, yeah.
Welcome to the run game where we go hard. Josh and Leo, we're the superstar. Talking Texans 22, we're in the zone. If you love the game, then come on home.
Ooh, yeah.
Come on home.
Ooh, yeah.
Come on
home.
What's up, everybody? It's Leon Josh with the Run Game Podcast on Texans 22. First of all, make sure y'all like, sub, and share. Check out the website, texans22.com, if you want to support us. Josh has a t-shirt hanging in his background. If you like it, go ahead and get one. We have a bunch of different options, water bottles and all types of stuff. And another way to support the channel, you can become a member. Members get earlier access to all of our videos.
If you're a member, you will get every question answered that you ask on the live streams. This is like a big perk to that. Like, no matter what we're doing, we will drop what we're doing and focus on what you ask.
And today, we're going to be talking about Kenyon Green, man. We got some good news about Kenyon Green. First 2 years of his career have been a rocky start with injuries. Played pretty much hurt the entirety of the first year of his career. Everybody says he's doing well, not even just what Aaron Wilson said on our live stream the other day.
He went to Oregon and was on the Nike campus and spent a lot of time there this offseason, and he's really transformed his body. He's under 320 pounds now, and at one point I believe he was about 350. He told me he's going to make people eat their words about it.
He's transformed his body and his time off. He took the year off last year and just focused on himself.
He played through that whole first year with that shoulder, battling these really high-level players. We don't really know the player. Like, we've seen the player, but you don't really know the players. He was just a shell of himself at that point. And the fact that he's gone 350 down to 320, if he's dropping that much weight and he looks like he does, the truth is his body fat level is probably way lower, because I'm sure he's added a ton of muscle underneath there. Obviously, he's a good run blocker, right? And that's going to get better with being strong. But I think the hidden thing is that anchor he's going to be able to play with this year. That's where he really struggled his first year. He had tonsil to his left, but everything else was a complete shit show that year. So going into this year, I think with his body getting stronger, he's getting lighter, but actually more sturdy. You're going to see that anchor just improve to a whole nother tier. And you're going to see him be able to set down versus guys. For a Texas A&M player, he was really damn good. And for him to start 3 years is a really high level thing, especially with the talent they were moving in around him. To see him take that level of play and moving it forward, I think it's going to be really impressive.
If he's healthy and obviously not a complete liability in pass pro, like he was his rookie year, unfortunately, he could be a piece that unlocks our run game. With him and Drew Scruggs next to each other, he helps us take advantage of the lighter boxes that we're going to see, especially like him getting into a second level onto like linebackers. I think there's a lot more upside with him than there is with Kendrick Green and those guys.
This is kind of a Texans fan favorite for guys is Jared Patterson. Maybe he's the one that pushes him at left guard. Patterson's probably the best pass pro guy out of all those options that maybe are pushing him if they're gonna go safe. Crazy to think that we had three out of our five that never really played last year at their spot that they're going to be playing this year, right? With Titus can be a solid right tackle, especially next to Mason. But then at center, combination of Scruggs finally playing center. So the fact that you're moving him over, it's like getting a brand new addition. It's almost like drafting another player at this point. And then you add in Kenyon Green, who didn't play last year. And according to how this offense is now, it's like drafting or adding another player. So in reality, we have three additions to the offensive line, and how well this system hides the issues that some of these guys might have, especially in the interior, where it's like tailor-made to cover up for deficiencies, gets you excited with how it can protect what Kenyon Green does bad and elevate what he does really good.
But one thing is for certain, that we have a little bit more options than we did before with these guys playing their right spot, man.
He was in probably the worst possible situation to be a good run blocker in that year in terms of the boxes he was seeing. There's going to be no excuses for him in the run game, specifically in the run game with those light boxes and him and Scruggs being able to work in tandem to work that second level like you talked about.
All right, y'all. So let us know what you think, man. Are you excited about Kenyon Green? So, man, make sure y'all like, sub, and share, man. The membership thing is a big deal to us. Become a member. Make sure y'all hit us up, man. All right, peace. Y'all
Welcome to the run game where we go hard. Josh and Leo, we're the superstar. Talking Texans 22, we're in the zone. If you love the game, then come on. Ooh.